So they don't see me yet. Uh-oh. See, what I notice when Buddy has another horse, he tends to move more. Because either he's following or the other one's following. And they tend to motivate each other to move more. When he's by himself, he sits in that damn stall up front and just stays underneath there. And there's no reason for him. Like, see, she's walking off, so he doesn't want to be left behind. So it forces him to walk and follow. I cut a little path out. That's where the trees are down, and there's a little path. I don't know why they're going in. There must be some good grass or something they want there in the back. I'm going to walk out here. They haven't seen me yet. But as soon as I hit this rock, they'll probably hear me. They're minding their own business. Just so the two donkeys are more calm when she's over here. Because the male donkey isn't trying to mount her and claim her. And there's no competition. So he doesn't beat up the old guy. So the white one is like, I don't know, something like 40 years old. And then the little black one is like 2 years old. So I still don't think Buddy saw me yet. I'm surprised neither one of them saw me. When I cross this, they'll usually hear. Okay, they must be far enough not to hear. He's getting on her butt. So he kind of went in where she was at. So see, her head's going up like she saw something. Look at Buddy. See, she saw something, and it made him go alert. And that's that herd instincts kicking in. And that's why I think he's more mentally aware when he has another horse. Because they feed off each other. I mean, to be honest, they seem like they pay more attention to each other when they've got the fence between them than when I put them together. So, look how dark Buddy got. Man, he's dark. So, there's a lady in Fort Worth that did a really nice picture of Buddy and Mr. T. I'll try to slide it in here if I remember. And I end up talking to her, and there's a Mustang rescue that is rescuing a lot of Mustangs. And evidently, they got five of them down in Decatur, which isn't that far from me. It's maybe an hour drive. So I told them I'd go out there and work. If I end up going out there, I can get some good footage of supposedly some wild Mustangs that need some work. And then maybe with my exposure and find some of them some homes too, or help find them homes. I don't know what Buddy and her saw, but they both saw something out there. Boy, they sure do seem like the flies are bugging them. Comes a vulture overhead. Noise can I make that they'll both look at the same time? See, I don't think they know what a lion or a tiger sounds like, and I can't do a really good tiger. Roar! Yeah, that worked pretty well. And that worked pretty good. So see, she's going off. She's going behind the targets. Man, it's like 60 or 59 degrees out here. With that wind, you would think the flies would be down. The clouds have been like wanting to rain all day, but we haven't got any rain. So I'm gonna walk and see how, oh shit, there's some new ant beds. I gotta get some ant food. see how long it takes for them to see me. Neither one of them saw me yet. If I was a predator, I'd be stuffing on one of them. There she goes. Let's see if she alerts Buddy. So she looked, but there wasn't really a concerned look, so Buddy didn't pick it up. Normally, if they stop eating, look at Buddy. Wonder what she's eating. Look, I just pushed her. She has been doing nothing but yelling since she's been over here. Every time he goes by her, she's like, meow, meow, just squealing. And so now he just kind of bumped her on perch. So I ain't worried about your damn squealing. Okay, so Buddy still hasn't seen me. I'm really surprised because he's usually pretty alert if I come out here. So see, she sees me. He's fine to sing, he just saw me. He's like, Dad, you ain't slick. Now sometimes he will walk up that hill. See that little white thing on top of the hill? That's a little bird, a little metal bird that I put up there. And sometimes he'll be up there eating right next to it. Whatever, Dad. I see you over there being a fool. Y'all didn't see me. I raised my hands up and looked like I was going to charge them. They both ignored me. So there must be some good vittles up that hill. Because they're both kind of like walking up the hill to eat it. Just a lot of dirt they pulled out when they were digging the pond, and I had them put it there so I'd have a backstop for my bullets. But for some reason they must have found something that tastes better up there. They got all this pasture that they could be eating, and they're standing on the side of one little hill. I mean, look at all this green grass. I'm surprised Buddy hasn't gone up there to kind of show off. Kind of create a little draw for her to go up there. I was not standing in an ant bed. He'll be stomping, kicking in a minute. It's amazing, man. These guys are just eating machines. I mean, you gotta figure they're 1,000, 1,200 pounds, and they're keeping all that weight and muscle on with grass. Thank you. So I'm at 3x zoom on my iPhone. So if I was on my Panasonic, I can get really close and zoom right in. It's got like 37 zoom, digital optical something zoom. But with this, I can only get so close. So she left and he left. So see, when she's in a room, the mood to roam, it causes him to move instead of standing around. All right. I came out here and was going to see if I could sneak up on them and maybe get a reaction, but they're too damn busy eating right now. So that's Bella and Buddy doing their sleepover, just eating. Buddy's on a mission. Get her, Buddy. He's like, hang on, I got itch. All right, now go get her. See if he passes her. Oh no, he's pushing her. She's like, get away from me, dude. Damn, guys. Always trying to mess up my program. Okay, so he walks up behind her and pushes her, and now he's gonna leave. And he'll create a draw on her. You guys sure do eat a lot. All this green grass. Man, Buddy really looks dark. It's almost as dark as her. All right, well, on that one there, they're out there being peaceful little horsies, content.